Your life is hidden with the Christ in God. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? You will not die before your time. I want you to talk to you about the mystery of a pattern of two. The prophetic figure and pattern mystery coded in the number two. You have two testaments older than you. You have two eyes and two arms. You have two ears. Then you have a mouth and a nose. You have ears and a mouth. Each of these must be used proportionately in agreement for you to move. If what you hear, if you only hear, but you don't know how to respond with your mouth, you are doomed. I don't think you hear. Are you listening to me? If you only see, but you don't know how, what you see in the physical eyes, that's why a believer has two sets of each and everything. I think you hear me. You live between two realms. I'm showing you, become conscious of the kingdom patterns. You have two legs, not one. When they cut one of your leg, or one leg becomes shorter, they don't say you are walking. You are what? Limping. Why? When one leg is shorter from the other, you limp. You don't walk. They see as a limp. Why? Because a limp is a disorder. I don't think you hear me. A limp is a disorder. You are given two legs, which means balance. Balance, which is the ability to live between two dimensions, between two dimensions, valleys, levels, without going on either extreme. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You have two eyes. Are you listening to me? But are you understanding the things I'm saying to us? So you live in two dimensions. There is the physical dimension and there's a spiritual dimension. But there is of always the two. There is always the spirit. The Old Testament, Jesus is in the Old Testament is a shadow, inferior. He is in the new spirit as Christ. You say, where is it written? It is in Colossians 2, verse 16 and 17. The verse 16 of Colossians 2:16 says, now, concerning the foods and the drinks, let no man have to judge you concerning such matters. For this, and of the Sabbaths and the new moon, for all the things existed as shadows, but they existed as shadows, but the reality, the substance, is Jesus Christ. So these are shadows. What is a shadow? It's a pattern. It's a pattern which serves as a signpost pointing you to the reality. Are you listening to me? When I started talking to you about patterns, I mentioned Isaiah 42 from verse 18. Do you remember? Who is blind but the one I send? Who is deaf like the one I am? Even when I point, he does not observe. He pays no attention. Ladies and gentlemen, your walk with God calls adequate attention to pay attention of every jot and detail of the scripture spoken to you. Are you listening to these things? Oh, maybe you answer. Oh, you are taking the city. I see you moving from one place to another. You are expanding. Somebody say, where you lack revelation, you don't listen to me, you cannot expand. Do you understand? We expand by revelation, not by excitement. You don't expand by confession alone. Confession without revelation is positive speaking. I don't think you heard me. Our confession as spirit beings must be backed up by revelation to differentiate us from motivational speakers. If you speak positively without revelation, you are a motivational speaker motivating yourself. And with motivation, there is no proof for backup. Who will back it up? But when you confess by revelation, you're speaking the word of God. You see, the utterances of revelation are just confessions of these utterances of revelations, which are confessions. Are you hearing me? This is what we call in Greek, confessions, homologia, which means to say the same thing as God says about you. But saying the same thing that God says about you with a revelation, that's without a revelation, there's no shifting. I don't think you remember. There is a man who called the captain of the armies of Israel. You remember Abishai? You remember Abishai and Joab? Remember when they ran to the house of the Lord? Because when David was pursued by Saul, he went and by the altar and held by on the horn of the altar by revelation. He knew an innocent man when he gets into the holy place and holds upon the horn of the golden altar, which is a horn, golden altar of incense, it symbolizes prayer. He held on the horn, a symbol of strength, relying on the Lord. That's why later he comes and said, "The Lord is my strength." He knew what he was doing. He did not hold the horn by information, by copy and paste, monkey see, monkey do. He held it by revelation. That's why nobody dared to come and get him. This other guy, is it Abishai or Joab? God, Joab holds onto the same horn and said, "Hey, I will die here." That is the very word they were waiting for. I will not come out. If I die, I die here. Now they knew he's holding that word, killed him. They knew how he doesn't know. He will die there. So they entered. Soldiers entered in the holy place, and the Lord never struck them, because a man has signed his death warrant by his mouth. Why? He has spoken. Although he's holding practically, he's holding on to something practically that spiritually is not connected to. He's seated in a church where he claims physically, "This is gracious ministry, my church." Practically holding on to the practicality, spiritually not connected, but he continues to sink. His life continues to go down. No vision, no visions, no relationship with God, because he's associated by what? Is it associated with a ministry based on practicality, not spirituality? Practicality that you associate. Hey, let me show up so Apostles Charles Sewanyana sees me, or I am encouraging him. Who told you needs your encouragement by attendance? We don't congregate to please. If you are associating with the body, thank you, you will get a body's anointing. Just a body. God will send you many here. But before God sends certain people, he wants to check your attitude. He wants to see, are you ready for what you're asking? Zoe means eternal life. When I see my English brother over there, a spirit man will understand that man is not seated there coincidentally. A prophetic eye understands that God is prophetically speaking to us about the nation, the natives, the indigenous people of this country. So then he sends one as a representative to test how you're going to treat him. How you're going to pray and nurture him and show him your God. So he gets to know and be built to a stature, because him, behind him, there are hundreds. Nobody is best positioned to reach the English than the English. And then he sits there, then he sends you that sister from which country is it? Latvia? From Bulgaria, as a prophetic symbol. But who is blind like the one my servant I send? He does not consider, he pays no, that these are not coincidences. And how should I go to the altar then to petition and they cry out? Because in her, there is a prophetess waiting to be released. That has to be released, but has to be nurtured. But you don't see beyond. And then you look at who didn't turn up at church. Yet, she becomes and he becomes your burden to carry them on the altar and to call his name. What's your name, brother? Terry. And you go on the altar in the night. "Father Terry, I come to you. Lord, I bring Terry. Lord, in the name of Jesus, as I pray, I go back into the books, the ancient books of this man's creation. I come to tap into his DNA. Whatever where his DNA was infiltrated by the enemy, interrupted, I come into the realm of the spirit. I demand the alignment of the record of his DNA. Karasuki ama umpra de zagada. Lord, I cry to you for Terry. And I cry to you for my sister who? Dimitrina. Because now, you may say God has sent me to the nations. But the nations, God will test you. First with those that he sends at you. God can't entrust you with nations until you are past the test of the ones he has put before you.